Hey guys and girls, how's it going? Welcome back to another episode of Feed the Beast Regrowth with myself, Lewis. Hope you're brilliant. Having yourself a great day as always. Now, I've been pruning my croppage. Sounds very good, doesn't it? And I've been making new areas. So we did already have the area here for breeding and splicing and mixing and churning and whatnot. And I needed more space. We're going to have to do that somewhere else. For now, we're going to have this area here, which is going to be for tin. I've made 4 seeds, and they're pretty much not doing a great lot of anything at the minute. But hopefully, they're going to start spreading. The iron ones took longer than the copper ones, as far as I'm aware. I might be wrong, but I feel like they took longer to spread. So I'm guessing the tin ones, again, are going to take longer than the iron ones, and so forth. We've also got these guys here. I made some mycelium, which is pretty easy to make. Mycelium is not that hard. You can use nature's essence to do that, or you can use one of the botania seeds. And I have the 2 different types of mushrooms going, as well as these guys here are neverworts, because we're gonna need these if we're to make any of the fire runes from botania, and they're gonna be used to make some of the new types of seeds that we need. So if we have a look inside here, and I got an unclaimed reward. Which one is that? Let's have a look. Is it this one? No. Is it you? That would probably help if I actually looked on here, yeah. It's you. Oh, it's because I got all the books, because I made the smeltery. There it is. Check that beast out. I made my smeltery, I made all the bits for it. I made it out of copper for the tool forge, purely because I had more copper at the time than I did iron, so there's that. I've been using this to smelt up ingots and things, which is cool, you know. Getting ourselves some of those. The main thing I've ran into, though, is I've realized that I can't actually use it just yet for making a better tool, because we need to make an alumite tool, and I don't think I have the ingredients to make alumite, because we need aluminium to be able to make alumite, and we don't have aluminium seeds. So I think it's going to be something that's going to turn up inside our book sooner or later. From one of these guys, some of these should allow us to do that. But let's look at these seed ones, because these are the ones I was talking about. Now, I've done all of these, which is good. I haven't done these 2 yet, because I still don't really feel the need to do them, but we're probably going to have to. But the next one is for Never Nefarity, and this allows us to make the seeds of the Never, you know, the horrible seeds of Neveriness, and we need to do that at some point. But I think what's going to happen is once I've done this one, it's going to open up more. That's why I'm hoping that we do that, and it gives me the access to be able to make aluminium. Hopefully. I'm not too sure on that, but hopefully we're going to be able to do that. Now, we did also make this stuff in the last episode, which gives us access to all of this stuff. We got these things as well. We got some blacksmith things. I don't even know what this thing does or something. Can I click on it? Like it's an assist, maybe. Oh, is it like a rack or something? Does it auto do it for us? If it auto does it for us, that's amazing. Let's put it like that. I don't know. Maybe something's going to happen. But I think the first thing that we're going to do today is we're going to try and carry on with some of these quests. Now, we can't do this one just yet. Actually, we might be able to do this one. Maybe it's going to be worth doing this one. The other one I wanted to go into was the botania seeds, and we also had some additional stuff here for moving into coal coke and making steel. Another thing that we need to do at some point is we need to set up an irrigation system. We've got these here for water tanks and irrigation. It's probably going to be a good idea to do that. Seeing as we made all of the fields quite even, it should be easy to set that up. So maybe we're going to do that at some point. It's a little bit of time, but I think it may be time well spent. Another one is an egg. Oh, yeah, no, that's going to be a good one. If we do the egg, then I think that allows us to do the cows. Let's have a look. Yeah. If we do the egg plus the lever gives us the cow, and that's going to be real handy if we can do that. So maybe it's going to be worth, was that a villager? Maybe it's going to be worth doing the egg first, which is a rune of mana and a rune of earth. And this is good because this means that we can make the runes that we need to make as well, because we need to go for all of the basic runes to hand in the next Botania quest. All right, we're almost done with our rune of mana. Any second now. Actually, I think it is done. Yeah, it looks done to me. All right, so we're going to need some living rock. Let's chuck you in the frying pan. And give you a little slap of the stick. Boom. one rune of mana. Oh my god, I think I almost blew my mic up then. It doesn't like the boom noises. There we go. So we got one rune of mana, which is great. So we're going to need that. We're also going to need a rune of earth, which can be very important. So let's have a look in here for the rune of earth. We're going to need stone, mushroom, mana steel, and a block of coal. So let's get some mana steel. We're going to need some of that. We need a block of coal. We're going to need some mushrooms. I think we can use any mushroom, but we'll just use the one that we got the most of. Because why not? Let's use a brown mushroom. And did I see three mana ingots? Yeah. All right. One, two, three. You can go back in there. And we're also going to need some stone. And that is it. Oh, block of coal. I can't forget that one. Let's grab nine of you. And a stone. And this is exactly what the quest book ordered. Let's go and do that. I think once we've done this, and we've got our chicken coop up and ready. That's saying we even actually get a chicken. What's the odds of getting a chicken in Minecraft? Like, it's pretty low, isn't it? I really hope that we do manage to get one. Oh my god, why have I got two ingots? Figure that ever happened. Pretend that I had three. Definitely had three. Yeah. Just you wait. Just you wait. It's coming. It's going to happen any second now. There we go. All right. So, there's one on there. Okie dokie. Right. We didn't do that. So, let's put you on there, you on there, you on there. And you. And boom. So, that's going to take a minute to do that. And once we've got that, that's going to give us three as well, which is pretty good. So, if we need to redo this, we can. Now let's look at the stuff we're gonna need to make an egg. We get 16. That's a pretty good chance, I think, of getting one. So we're gonna need a pasture seed, we need a mandrake seed, and a regular seed. What if I got any regular seed? Yeah, there we go. And we're gonna need a mandrake seed. So let's go get one of those from the witchery box over this way. There we go. We use one of these ones. We've got more of them, which generally means that they're not as good as the ones by themselves. I keep saying I'm going to identify stuff. I really should, because everyone keeps asking me to. I will do it eventually. One day. When is that day? Well, I don't know yet. But we will do it. Eventually. And we did just get some more experience drops, which is good. We use these eventually for something good. Making cows, which is one thing. Cows is one thing I need because I would like to get cows to get an easier source of leather. Because getting leather at the minute is a little bit of a pain. I don't actually know how we got leather. Like, we've got leather, but I can't remember where we got leather from. Seriously, I can't actually remember where we got it from. I didn't make an alchemy catalyst, did I? We could make an alchemy catalyst now. Hmm. It's looking pretty juicy, if you ask me. Alright, so let's put you on there. And you. And now, we should be able to get ourselves some eggs. So we need you, and you. We need a regular seed. Mandrake seed. And a pasture seed. And that should hopefully do the trick for us. Oh, we're missing a dirt seed as well, yeah. Okay. Good times. Oh, this actually means as well that I can make something truly amazing, which I'm going to do right now, because we can't live without this, and it's far too important in my life to not have. I don't know how I've lasted this long without it, but now is the time to make it. Unless we've already made it. No, we haven't made runes of earth yet, have we? No. Otherwise I would have it on me at the minute. There's no way I wouldn't have this on me if I already made it. So, we want you. And I know exactly. Some of you guys are thinking, oh no, he's making it again. I am. Now, oh, other way around. Boom, one rod of the lands. Now I can place my dirt. Oh, that's so good. I love how, like, every playthrough, I pretty much always have a rod of the lands somewhere around. All right, okay. So do I just use living rock again? Is that how we do this? And it gives us eggs? Yes. All right. So where are we going to do this? Eventually, I'm going to set up an area just for animals, much like we have an area just for farming crops. But for now, we need to find a place to put this. So I'm thinking we're going to put it over this way. Let's use our dead wood because we got buttloads of it. We might as well use it up. And that's not what I'm looking for. Oh, what do we need to get sticks? Oh, we can. Brilliant. There we go. So we'll do you. And let's make a gate first. Oh, we've got some more sticks there as well. Good stuff. Let's make a gate as well so we can at least get into our place. There we go. And some more. Nice. All right. So I think we're just going to, for now, pop it here. And hopefully we'll be able to get more chickens, which is going to be very important. So let's go inside here and oh, please give me a chicken. Yes. All right. We got a baby chicken. Now we need, come on, at least give me one more. Yes. Okie dokie. All right. Two chickens is pretty good for 16 eggs, I think. I don't know. Maybe. I think it's close. But that allows us to do another quest as well, I think. Yeah. It was one of these ones was all about eggs and making different mobs. So let's have a looky-see. Yeah, there we go. Cool beans. So that does that one. That gives us, oh, it gives us another 16 eggs. All right. Let's see what we can get out of this. There's one more. Oh, sorry, I didn't mean to do that. Don't nibble on my feet. Oh, we got another one. Oh, if you go mental like that, you're gonna get hit. All right, we do up this way. You know what? I'm gonna take that. We got four for the price of 32 eggs. I think that's not that bad. I'm gonna say we got a winner chicken dinner right there, literally. So we're not gonna eat them yet because we're gonna make sure that they grow nice and healthy to give me more eggs and feathers and things. I don't actually know if chicken shed is on this. Like, I know we've got Britannia, but I don't know if Britannia's chicken shed option is enabled. So I guess we'll find out about that. But if it is enabled, it means the chickens are gonna drop their feathers as they do their chicken stuff around their little pen. So maybe they'll do that. I don't know. But if not, we've got chickens now, so we can breed chickens, which is great. And that's gonna allow us to go on to making cows as well. Now, another quest that we did get that I would start looking into is all of these, because we've got all these things here to make the scuba gear, which we never actually did, and I think it's something that we should do at some point. So let's have a look if we've got all of the required materials to do that, because eventually we're going to go into oysters. I don't know if they're actually going to be useful to us, but we are going to want to do it. Let's have a look. Have we got any? Actually, I don't think I've ever had any leather. I was saying earlier, I was like, oh, where do we get our leather from to begin with? I don't think we've actually ever had any leather. Where did I get it in my head that we had leather? Was it from the books? Because I think we used the blank patterns. I think that's why. Yeah. That would be it. We never actually use leather. All right, knock that one on the head. So let's go into the witchery stuff. This is one thing that I would like to do. I think it's going to be fun. And then at some point, we'll make the rest of the runes for the Britannia one. But I've been wanting to do this for some time because I haven't played with witchery in a long time. And one of these lets us do it. Here we go, yeah. So we got a new quest. We originally only had this one here. We've now got this one for funneled fumes, which is pretty interesting. So capturing fumes in a jar in your witch's oven is hard. You only seem to succeed about 30% of the time. As you've been trying to come up with the way to increase the rate of fume collection, observation of the other witches has led you to discovering the device known as the fume funnel. A single oven can be upgraded with up to 3 funnels to the sides and the top. However, the one on the top will not increase the chances of fumes, just the smelting speed of the oven. Later, you can upgrade your fume funnels with a fume filter to increase the chance of fumes and the smelting speed of the oven. So the main thing we want to do at the minute is we want to make sure that we have the funnels on the sides of it, not the top of it, because I'm not really too fussed about the speed of it yet. That, you know, that's more of a luxury than anything else, but making sure that we get the fumes is pretty good. So let's have a look at what we need to make a fume funnel. And we can't make the filtered fume funnel just yet. Yeah, because we need an attuned stone. We need a altar to be able to do that. But we can do this one. So we need 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. We need 5 buckets, loads of iron. They're not cheap, but we have got the iron to spare at the minute. And I'm getting a pretty decent amount of iron from that field over there. We've almost got like 2 stacks, and I've made a pretty decent amount since then as well. We're also going to need one of these. So let's get ourselves some glowstone. I only got some glowstone from Zinevaz, which is great, so we can grab you. And we're also going to need a little bit more iron because we're going to need to make some more buckets. We needed how many buckets? 5 buckets to do this. So we're going to need another 3 buckets. So 4. Oh, man, we're going to need a little bit more. There we go. Good stuff. Now I haven't got the block of iron. Oh, no. What am I doing? Oh, there we go. We got the one in there. Okay, so there's that. We got the buckets. We got the iron. We need the iron bars. I think for now, one's going to have to do the trick. But this will increase our chances of getting one by 30%. And it should hand the quest in. I think it's only to make one fume funnel. Yeah. So that will allow us to go from there. We're probably going to have to make the witch's, the herbalist's guidebook at some point. So we can actually, that might bring up more quests. But for now, I think this will do the trick. So let's get ourselves a bucket of lava. And we will, we'll put you together. So we wanted a iron bar, two blocks of you. We want some of this stuff, this guy, and you. Sweet. All right, and it gave me out one bucket. Oh my lord, it actually took up four buckets. That's really expensive, isn't it? It's a lot expensive than you think it would be. It's probably not worth it, but I guess it's one thing. It does look cool, though, when it's been placed down, doesn't it? I do like that. And I think it looks a little bit different on this side as well when you place it on there, so. Yeah, pretty cool. And that gives us 32 clay jars, which I'm never going to turn, my nose down at that. We got another 64 jars in there, which is pretty cool. Oh, look, they're dropping feathers. That means chicken shed is on. Yes. That's amazing. So we're going to have to make sure that we have adequate room to supply our chickens. I think what we should do is make a chest just for chicken goods. So we'll have feathers in there for now, and eventually we'll have other things in there. It might be worth as well making a one over there for all our fumey stuff. I know we've got a chest for our flowers from witchery, but it might be handy to have one just for fume related goods. So if we have our clay jars in there and any fumes that we get from that as well, is going to be pretty good. That brings us to that one. So the next one, I think, which opens stuff up is this one. Yeah, on herbology. And this is what it's all about from witchery, I think. So for this, we get essence, books, and experience drops. And we need a herbology from witchcraft. So let's have a look at the herbology. See what it's going to cost us. It's going to cost a stick, a dandelion, a poppy, and some ink. All right. I think we can do that, I think. Let's have a look. We got a dandelion. Do we have a poppy? Yes. We need a stick. We need a book. Already got one out. And we need some... Can we use floral powder? Are you going to let me use floral? Black dye? Floral? Yeah, of course you are. Good stuff. All right. So we just need a black flower or a black petal. And then we'll be able to do that one as well, which is going to be great. So let's have a look. We need you. Cool beans. Let's get you out of the bag. And you'll be able to do that for me. Cool beans. We might as well do, we might as well make two. Because why not? And we'll put the other one in there. We're eventually going to need it for something or another, so we might as well. Oh, look. Yes. We got some more. I love that we can now double our ores. It makes life so much easier. Someone did point out on one of the previous episodes that there's no point in doubling our ores inside the mariculture one because we only get 1.5, so we only get an extra 50%, whereas with this we get double. So we might, you know, I would save my ores up just for being able to do that. But there we go. So that gives us this, which runs us through all the different things to do with herbology. So we've got the belladonnas, which we already have. The we haven't actually got ember moss, so maybe we need to try and get that. We've got glintweed, mandrake, snowbell, Spanish moss, wild brambles one, ender bramble, void bramble, grasper. I know what the grasper is. Critter snare. Oh, there's quite a few, isn't there? A blood poppy, wispy cotton. A lot of this stuff we don't actually get from using the mutandis, though. Like the wispy cotton, I think you get from the dream world. So, yeah. But we will place it in here anyway. And this should do the quest for us, which hands us all these. And we're starting to rack up a decent amount of experience drops as well, which is going to be real handy. I haven't been using them because I have no need to use experience just yet. But it looks like some of the crafting recipes later on are going to be using these. So I think holding on to those is a pretty well worth idea. How are we doing, chickens? Have you got any more goods for me? Are you handing out the feathers? No? That's all right. We've already got three and you're fairly young. I'm happy to wait for now, but if you don't start producing the goods within at least a week, I'm going to be mortally disappointed. Alright, so this should have opened up enough of a quest for us inside this one. Yeah. Oh, yeah. So this one, is, I guess this is going to be to get the Spanish moss. There are a few unusual plants that you're encountering while using Mutandis. It might be worth retaining a sample of them in case they come in handy in the future. So we need to make some shears. And this is going to give us, and that's going to give me snowbell seeds. Like, I got snowbell seeds I got before, and they were like a pain to get. So, yeah. I guess if you're just starting now, I guess it's worth hanging on to it, because that gives us snowbell. And what do we need? We need ember moss and Spanish moss. Alright. Mutandis. Okie doke. And we're also going to want some bone meal. So let's see if we can get these guys. I'm going to do it. I'm just going to get rid of these, because we only need one, don't we? So we'll get rid of you. Get rid of you. And you. And let's give this a try. So that's a birch. Spruce. Rowan. Dandelion. Aha! Ember moss is the one that we need, so you can come with me. Thank you very much. And the last one was Spanish moss, wasn't it? Yeah, Spanish moss. So we're going to have to do this one last time. It's fine. Let's throw down our bone meal. Where you at? There you are. Let's grab all of this stuff. Who knows? Maybe we'll get ourselves some more Mutandis. Oh, there we go. Got some floral fertilizer. Not going to say no to that. Let's see if we can get some Spanish moss from you. How much we got? Oh, we got buttloads of the stuff. It's holding out, isn't it? Come on. Give me Spanish moss. We're on 12. Oh, my geez. Don't do this to me. Ooh, that was close. I was getting real worried then we wasn't going to be able to get that, but luckily, we're able to. Good stuff. So that gives us the other two that we need. Is there another quest? No. That gives us snowbell seeds. Sweet. We don't actually need snowbell seeds because I've already got a load of them, but I guess that's useful nonetheless. Allows us to make wolf's bane and wormwood. So I think those are going to be ones we're going to have to go into eventually. Makes wispy cotton. Wormwood, wispy cotton. I don't really understand that. Is that like a byproduct chance or something? Mandrake. It's actually going to be worth doing these because we're going to need to do these very soon. So I think that's probably going to be the next part that we need to do. Let's have a look. Hello, Poppet. Hello, Poppet. One of the best parts of being a witch is messing with people's heads. One way to do this is with poppets. Small dolls which can be toggled or tag-locked people. You can use poppets either to produce or protect yourself from a number of harms, or you can use them with a tag-lock bound to other creatures to deal harm to them. Use the tag-lock on a being when they aren't looking or on their bed, and you'll have a tag lock bound to them to use as you please. Whether your intentions are nefarious or nice is your business. I like that. I've used these before. Like, they're quite fun. So, yeah. But it's another quest that we need to do. So let's get all this stuff inside here. We had our... Where's our fiery ones? There they are. Good stuff. And we had buttloads of you, didn't we? Let's see if we can get all this in here. I got, like, a spare one just for all this stuff. I don't want you in there. Belladonna, yeah. And you can go back in there. Alright, so that's gonna do alright for now. So we need to make a tag lock kit and a poppet. I don't even know how we make a poppet. Let's have a look at making a poppet. Poppet. Poppet, poppet. Let's have a look. We need some Spanish moss, a bone needle, and some string. Alright, well let's figure out where we're going to place our Spanish moss. I'm thinking we might actually just do it over here, because I've left some spare spaces along the sides here just for this sort of stuff. We could even have it running like all along here. I think it would work. So if we like place you there, it should spread. And if it doesn't spread, I can spread it myself. Let's have a look at the stuff that we also need for a bone needle. I think it's literally just a bone. Yeah, bone and a flint gives us that. Let's see if we've got any bones. I don't actually know if we have any bones. If we don't have bones, then we do have the skeleton seeds. And they have been slowly producing the goods. Although it has taken some time. Let's have a look. We've got bone meal. Well, we're going to need a flint. And we got string now, which is good. Plus the cotton seeds. I actually want you in there. Yeah, you can go out of there. Put you back in there. Good stuff. There you go. I don't know how many of these I need, though. Like, is that enough? Oh, that's more than enough. We only need 3, and it gives us a buttload. That's insane. All right, so we can do you, gives us 10 of those. And then we need one of you, and one of you gives me my bone needles. Sweet. And what do we need for a tag lock kit? It's probably going to be like a little, yeah, a little glass ball. Let's get free you. Good stuff. So that's going to give us you, and then we need you, and poof. Brilliant. Now, we can use these on ourselves, which is real handy. I'm going to place the rest of you in there, I think. Because, we, you know, they're going to come in useful sometime, aren't they? So that's the tag lock kit. And let's see if you've done any growing. I don't know if I can actually speed up the growth of vines. Like, is that even a thing? I guess we can try. I've never actually tried this before. I've never thought about, you know, speeding up the process of vines. But maybe. Like, this is what I mean, though. Like, everything's grown. And you guys haven't done your thing yet. So maybe you're not. Maybe you're going to take your time. I'm not going to moan. Like, I'm going to let you do your thing. But I guess it's definitely doing something, isn't it? Yeah, you're gonna take your time, aren't you? Maybe going into the irrigation side of things isn't such a bad idea. If it speeds up the growing of all of our crops, then that's great. I'm all about that. So maybe that's one of the next, like, kind of big projects that we should go into, actually properly irrigating all of these fields to make sure that we have a decent amount of... Oh, man, I shouldn't have done that. Actually, no, that's fine. Oh, I shouldn't have done that. Because now they're not going to spread. I'll leave you. Oh, no. Yeah. So, I think the next big thing is going to be irrigation. Because that's just, you know, it's going to speed everything up tenfold, isn't it? If we do that. And, it, you know, it's one of those quests we probably should have done a long time back. Let's have a look. What the world enables. That's not you. Embraces? Yeah. Water U1. This leads on to water tank sidings. So we need 5 water tank sidings. I don't even need a water tank. But if we make one, it leads us onto that. Which I guess is going to be handy. Let's have a look. So we need iron. We need pipe sealant. And we need palm wood. And we need a few of these. Let's have a look. Let's get some cactus. Oh, we got boatloads of cactus now. It's great. So, how many do we want to cook up? Let's cook up 8. I guess. We'll use our charcoal again. There we go. Oh, I just had a spider. Where are you? You out here? Oh, he's out there somewhere. Doing spider stuff. No. Oh, I can hear him again. Where are you at? I can hear a spider. I can hear, it's like a phantom spider. He's here somewhere. Doing spider things. Where are you hiding out? No. Maybe he's like all over there. Maybe he's underground. Like, you know, the base below me is still there, actually. The original base that we had in like the first episode. I never filled it in. It's like under here somewhere. I think maybe it's still there. Ooh, we might have an infestation downstairs. That's not brilliant. Might have to watch out for that one. But hey-o. All right, so cactus and that spider is going to drive me mental. Luckily, we haven't got much longer on today's episode. So we're going to want you. And the music's going to help, though. And we're going to want some of this. And this should allow us to make these. Why are you not going in the bag? Let's do this. There we go. And we need some iron. And, oh, I know why it's not going in there. I didn't change it around, did I? There we go. So, how many do we need? Oh, man, I can't add this up to save my life. We're just going to do all of these and hope for the best. We need... Is that 9? 18? 9? 18? 20? 25? 26 or somewhere around there. Although we're going to need a place to set this up. If we're going to have the water come in from... Do I even want the water coming from this tank, though? I really don't know. You know, it's a quest off the list, but... I guess we should set it up somewhere, shouldn't we? Where should we do it? Like, we could do it in between that area. I know it's going to look a little bit strange, but that actually might be a good place to do it. Because if we do run the irrigation from the tank, then we're going to want it higher up, aren't we? Because the irrigation works a little bit differently with Agricraft. So maybe we're going to kind of want it starting around here and then making its way out and crossing out. Like, you know, that could be a way of doing it. Who knows? Let's give it a try. So if we do you and we do it this way. It's been ages since I built one of these, by the way. So we'll do you. And do this. Oh, there we go. Oh, we're a little bit short, aren't we? Dang. All right, let's go make one set more. I like how it makes it in a way that you have to spend more. It's like, yeah, you have to make a little bit more than that. You have to try a little bit harder than that, boy. All right, so we're gonna need some of you. And we'll make one more. And that should do the trick for us. Let's see how fast this fills up as well. Yeah, there we go. So it's slowly going up. I have a feeling. I can't remember, but I remember doing a spotlight on Railcraft a long time ago. Like, we're talking like 2 years ago. And I'm pretty sure these guys fill up faster in particular biomes. So I might have to look into that. Maybe we'll move this over to like a sea biome. And that might do the trick for us. I need to double check that. It's been so long since I've done Railcraft stuff. I can't remember. Maybe one of you guys knows. But yeah. But that's basically going to slowly fill up with water for us. And then we can use that to irrigate our plants, which is going to be super cool. I think stuff can spawn up here as well. So maybe it's going to be worth, you know, putting a couple of torches around the top. Good stuff. And hopefully you can see what I'm getting at here. That we will have, like, basically think of the irrigation as, like, a pipe. It kind of is a pipe, but it's not. And it's going to come out this way. And then it's going to kind of, you know, section off. And then we'll have sprinklers coming off the roof. I think that's going to work. I think that's going to work really well. It's going to cost a little bit, though. But I think most of it's just wood. So it shouldn't be all that bad. But yeah, we're going to need to do this. So this is just irrigating. So maybe your crops would grow faster if you set up an irrigation system to water them, keeping them well hydrated. Irrigation channels are not pipes. They will not carry water uphill. The sprinkler must be placed on the bottom of an irrigation channel and will consume water to accelerate crop growth. So we're going to have to make all of this. Most of it's made of wood. So, you know, it's not really expensive. It's just we need a lot of wood. And we're going to bring this out. We'll section it off. We'll have the sprinklers. It'll work. I also want to make a particular area for farming because we're starting to get into the point now where we can make chickens. And, oh yeah, producing the feathery goods. And we can also look into making cows now as well, which is another amazing thing. So overall, we're coming along quite nicely. Nice. By the way, I do feel like a complete idiot. Just letting you know right now before we finish the episode off. I totally forgot why these things aren't growing. I was literally about to finish the episode and I was like, oh my god. You know what? We need to put these down, don't we? They're not going to grow if we don't place down the crop sticks. See, this is what happens when you take a couple of days off from doing YouTube and playing games and things. Your mind just goes to kaput. Oh my god, it's already spread. Yeah, we need to place those down. It's, you know, it's been like 3-4 days since I've been on it. You can blame me if you will, but I blame me. Yeah. All right, guys, that's it for today's episode. I hope you enjoyed it. If you have, of course, you can subscribe. If you're new to the channel, feel free to give it a like. Have yourself a great day. Have a good one as always, and bye-bye.